Yeah, continue the fifth page. In this page, today we learn the fourth and the fifth problem. Page number is 283. Be carefully listen very neatly. Are you understood of that all of that three problems? Understood? Three bits understood?
Understood.
15-point exercise, 15.2. Yeah, next continue the fourth and the fifth problem. First of all, I will read your textbook. Be carefully listen very neatly. Yeah, state whether the following statements are true or false. Yeah, look at that blackboard also. When here it is there, questions also there. Then say, yeah, once I read the blackboard, we can look at the blackboard. We can do this, but give me fourth one. State whether the following statements are true or false. First one, every closed figure has an axis of symmetry. Is it true or false?
Yes. I think so.
One by one, the solution for us is it? Yeah, every closed figure has an axis of symmetry. Yeah, no. If it's every closed figure, some closed figures are not have an axis of symmetry.
False.
So that's why you can look at every closed figure. This is a closed figure. But you are not have any axis of symmetry. Okay, na? All are shapes of the different shapes. It's like shapes is also are not closed figure. But it is a closed figure. But you are axis of symmetry? No. So that's why it is a false, true or false?
False.
Next, second one. A figure with at least one axis of symmetry is called a symmetric figure.
No,
a figure
false.
With at least one axis of symmetry.
I think so, false.
Any figure with at least one axis of symmetry is called as a symmetric figure. So that's why it's
true.
Sorry, but I'll answer that. Next one is the third one. A regular polygon of 10 sides will have 12 axes of symmetry. But a regular polygon is 10 sides only. So that's why it is a false. So you understood of the fourth bit, it's over. Now next goes to the fifth one. Given a square and draw all its axes of symmetry. If you say, first of all, I read in my textbook, that's why. If you say, are you the problem? Yeah, big question only. So that's why it is reading, but don't write it only. You are not blackboard, only given data, I can write down only. So that's why, first of all, I read in my textbook only. Construct a square and draw all its axis of symmetry and measure the angles between each pair of successive axis of symmetry. What do you notice? Does the same rule apply for other regular polygons? Yeah, what's are given data in one given problem? If you say construct a square you can draw here. It is all axis of symmetry you can draw the first of all, you can square, you can draw the all axis of symmetry can draw it is, and next you can find out what's the find out the measures of the angles between each pair of successive axis of symmetry. And then what's the can measure of angles are the sum of all angles you can measure of each pair of the successive axis of symmetry. You can in any polygon you can write it. What do you notice? And does the same rule apply for other polygons, other regular polygons? You can, that is the to find the last graph. Two questions are there in three questions. You can one by one today we will learn the solution. You can write out the solution. You can say the same given data a square and draw all of its axis of symmetry to find the measure the angles between each pair of successive axis of symmetry. And what do you notice? And does the same rule apply for other regular polygons? Is it correct or wrong? If you say one by one, you can subtract, you can learn this problem. Your first question is the square and draw. Draw the square.
Draw the second square.
Okay, na? And if on the axis of horizontal, you can say axis of the it is horizontal. And vertical is also lambda. And next is also diagonal is also lambda. The four axis also like this. Okay, na? This is the center point. If I have on our axis, the axis of the drawing is also better. Yeah, this is the axis of symmetry, it's over and we can measuring the angles between each pair of the successive axis of symmetry. But yeah, the square is all of the angles are most of the 90 degrees of angles. Each angle is that 90 degrees and 4. How many 90 degrees angles? 4 angles are 90 degrees. Total is the 4. Okay, na? 4. So 360 degrees. And 4. 90 cross of 3, 4 equal to 360 degrees. Yeah, total sum of that all of that angles in one square is 360 degrees. So the square is 490 degrees. So the square is the first one is the measuring of the angles between the each pair of the axis of symmetries. Measuring that is the angles, the sum of the angles between each pair. This is like upon each pair. This is the 90 degrees. This one is the 90 degrees. This is also 90. This is also 90. So that's why the total is the 360 only. So that's why it is the 90 degrees. And if it's two pairs are there. So that's why this is the 45 degrees and this is also 45 degrees only. Okay, are you understood? Absolutely. And then the sum of the angles between each pair of successive axis of symmetry any polygon equal to the 360 degrees. Okay, now. Okay, the angles Axis of symmetry equal to angle of symmetry equal to in any polygon equal to 360 degrees. So that's why it is the first one is the 360 degrees by 2n only. So that's why this is the one quarter, can be the 45 degrees only. First one is the each pair of that this both are only 90 degrees. So that's why it is the two pairs only. So that's why it is the each one is the quarter, the sum of the angles. How many angles are for axis of symmetry is there only? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 only. So that's why it is the 360 by 8. Otherwise you can substitute this like 360 degrees by 2n. 2 into n means is the 4 angle. 4 is the 90 degrees of 4 angles. So that's why it is the 8 only. And then 360 by 8. 8 by the 8 and 8 8 4 to 32. And next is the 8 5 to 40. So that's why it is the 45 degrees. You can understand what I'm saying? Each one and the angles between the each pair of successive axes of a symmetry in any polygon equal to 360 degrees. So that's why it is the each pair of this like each pair of the angles between that successive axis of symmetry equal to 45 degrees only. 45 degrees and 360 by 2n only. So that's why 2 into n, n means is the 4 only. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's why it is the 4 only. And equal to the, let them other by the sum of the angles. So that's why 360 by 8. So you will get this like to the each of this sum of the angles is the 45 degrees only. Okay, you can understand. Yeah, what's the next question? So what do you notice and does the same rule apply for the for other regular polygons, yes, this is on the true only. This is true, the same rule apply for the other polygons only. Okay, understood, understand? Therefore, this is, yes. That's the what do you notice and yes, this is true only. Yeah, this is true. And each angle is the 45 degree. తీసుకున్నాం. సో టోటల్ ఏంటంటే 88 యాంగిల్స్ ఉంటుంది. సో దట్స్ వైన్ 360 డిగ్రీస్. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ద ట్రూ అండ్ సో దిస్ ఈజ్ ట్రూ అండ్ ఇక్కడ మోస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ ద దిస్ ఈజ్ ట్రూ సేమ్ రూల్ అప్లై ఫర్ సేమ్ రూల్ రెగ్యులర్ పాలిగన్ మీన్స్ ద మోస్ట్ వన్ ఇన్ ద ఆల్ సైడ్స్ ఆర్ ఆల్ యాంగిల్స్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ అండ్ సో దట్స్ వైన్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ రూల్ apply for other regular polygons. Other regular polygons. Okay, that means you need to understand. Yeah, first answer is yes. This is true. You can use this label. The same rule apply for the other polygons only. You can have okay, na? Each of the successive axis is equal to the 45 degrees only. Okay, na? All sides and all angles are equal. Regular polygons. Okay, na? Are you understood of this bit? Today our 15th exercise, our 15.2 all problems and solutions is also is over. And next goes to today's class is also over. See? Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.